Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss the linearity assumption. This is an important test assumption, especially for the multiple regression analysis. Linearity assumes that the correlation between variables is linear. So in order to test this assumption, we need to examine the bivariate correlation for each pair of variables to make sure that we do not detect any nonlinear correlation. To test the bivariate correlation, we go to Analyze, select Correlate, and choose Bivariate. Then we select X6 to X18, which are independent variables in each batch dataset. We will use Pearson two-tail test, so we check Pearson and two-tail, click OK. Spss Output shows us the Pearson correlation coefficients between all pairs of variables along with the significance level. Note the asterisk in this table. One asterisk means the correlation is significant at the significance level of 0.05, and two asterisks mean the correlation is significant at the level of 0.01. In this output, we observe many significant correlations and many non-significant correlations. Some correlations are negative and some are positive. Significant correlations indicate the linearity, which meets the linear assumption. However, we are concerned with non-significant correlations. Basically, in these cases, the linearity is not apparent. So the question would be whether we have a non-linearity in these cases. Nonlinearity is a serious violation of the linearity assumption. To detect nonlinearity, we use scatter plots, which will help identify the pattern of the data. A straight line pattern shows linearity. If the plot shows random pattern, it indicates no correlation at all. This is considered acceptable for the linearity assumption. If the plot shows a nonlinear pattern, such as exponential curve or parabolic curve, we will have the nonlinearity issues and data transformation may be needed. We can build one scatter plot at a time, but it will be very time consuming. There is a better tool to build all plots at once. We go to graphs and select graph board template chooser. Then we select X6 to X18. On the right side, we select scatter plot matrix, which will show all scatter plots between all pairs of variables. Click OK. This is a more effective way to build the plots. Note that it may take some time for SPSS to build the plots. Here is SPSS output. On the diagonal, we have the histogram of each variable. And off the diagonal, we have the scatter plot for each pair of variables. I would like to view all plots at the same time, and it is hard to do with SPSS output. So I will copy and paste this graph to a Word file. I open a new Word document, change the page to landscape to have more room for the graph. To copy the graph, we click on it and right-click, and then select Copy. It takes some time to copy. Now we go to Word and paste. This is the scatter plot matrix, which is a big graph. We'll need to examine all plots. In this video, we'll discuss some typical examples. For example, we see a straight line pattern with this plot, which indicates the linear correlation or linearity between these two variables. And we can compare this with the Pearson correlation table we have before. We see some clear linearity patterns in this graph. On the other cases, we can observe random patterns indicating non-significant correlation between variables. As discussed before, this is not a major concern regarding the linearity assumption. The major concern is with any nonlinearity patterns such as parabolic or exponential curves. In this case, we do not see such patterns. Accordingly, we can conclude that we do meet the linearity assumption. This is how to test the linearity assumption using SPSS. Thank you, and bye now.